alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All thanks be to Almighty Allah, who has given us the opportunity to witness this year's Ramadan. May He give us the opportunity to witness more of it on the surface of the earth and grant us abundant reward in this year's Ramadan and others to come. Ameen. My name is Oshoa Abdulhakim. I will be taking you the revision class for my SS3 students. I would like us to start our revision class with longitude and latitude. You know, in our previous class, in our original class, we talk about longitude and latitude. So we talk about the earth surface. You know what we mean by the earth surface? We talk about the earth. You know what we mean by the earth? We said the earth is spherical in shape. The earth is approximately spherical in shape. It rotates about its axis. That is what we have been told during our social studies class when we are in junior class, and those of us that offer geography. We know the earth is approximately spherical in shape, but we assume it to be spherical in shape here, so that it will help us to, so that we'll be able to do the calculations that we want to do here. So I said the earth is spherical in shape. It is approximately spherical. So we talk of longitude and latitude. You said longitude and latitude are imaginary lines drawn on the surface of the earth. The earth is spherical with approximate radius of 6,400 kilometers, and it is denoted by the letter R, capital letter R. You know, we said latitude, they are the imaginary lines drawn across the earth's surface, but it is drawn horizontally, while the longitudes are drawn vertically. Now, we talk of equator. This, you know, it's a revision class. We just to remind us of what we have done initially. The equator is the intersection of a horizontal plane with the earth surface through the center of the earth. That is, you remember we said the equator is the one that divides the earth into two horizontally. It divides the earth into two equal parts horizontally. Other latitudes we now proceed. We now have other ones from that equator, which we assume to be the 0 degree. Then we now measure to the pole, either the north pole or the south pole. Parallel of latitudes are intersection of other horizontal plane with the earth's surface, resulting in circles that are parallel to the equator but less than the equator in length. The radius of the parallel of latitude is less than the radius of the earth, hence they are called small circles. The radius of this parallel of latitude is denoted by small letter R. Remember we said the radius of the earth is denoted by the capital letter R. So that means there are two different types of circles. There are different types of circles. We have the great circles, or we say the big circles, and the small circles. So the small circles are all other parallel of latitude. All latitudes are called small circles, except the equator. Equator is also a latitude, but that one is at the middle, is the one that divides the earth into two. So a great circle, it has the same radius with the longitude. Longitude two divide the earth, every longitude we also divide the earth. The full longitude, we also divide the earth into two equal parts. The full longitude, that means the complete circle of a longitude. You know, latitude are complete circle. One from this side, then the other one from the other side. Then likewise for the longitude also. For the one side, then at the other back of the side. The complete one also divides the earth into two equal parts. So we call all the longitude great circles. We call the latitude small circles, except the equator, that it is also a great circle. So I said the radius of the earth, the radius of the parallel of latitude is denoted by small letter R, and it is equal to the great circle. The radius of the earth calls the latitude, the degree of the latitude, so which we normally represented by alpha, where alpha is the latitude 2 points, and r, which is the radius of the earth, which is what? 6,400 kilometers approximately. The equator is greatest among the parallel of latitude, with its radius equal to the radius of the earth, as I've said initially. And the equator is a great circle. Is a great circle. All other longitudes are also great circle. I think I've explained that one too. Measurements of latitude are in degrees to the north and or to the south of the equator. You know, I said the equator is the one at the middle that divide the earth into two equal parts. So we measure one to the north, we measure other ones, the other circles to the north, the other, and then other ones to the south. All of them like that, they are called latitude. So maximum is 90 degrees to the north and 90 degrees to the south. So that is the top. The one at the top will be 90 degrees to the north, and why the ones at the south, the poles, they are 90 degrees to the north and 90 degrees to the south. Measurements of longitude are in degree to the east or west. So whichever one, because all the longitude, they have the same radius, they are all equal in size. So we measure it to the east and to the west, east or west, either of the two. So the maximum longitude are 180 degrees to the east or 180 to the west. So the two, 180 degrees to the east and 180 degrees to the west, the two of them coincide. For example, now if we talk about a circle, a complete circle is 360 degrees. We know we are starting from somewhere. If we pick a place that this is 0 degrees, so we are starting our measurement. So at the end of the day, when we will get to 360 degrees, it will now fall on that 0 degrees. So 0 degrees and 360 degrees, they are on the same point. So that is what we are talking about here too. 180 degrees to the east and 180 degrees to the west, the two of them also fall on the same place. So we now look at the relationship between the radius of parallel of latitude and radius of the earth. You know, radius of the earth, that is a line from the center of the earth to any part of the surface of the earth, that will give us the radius. If you look at the diagram, you will see we have the north pole, the south pole, the east and the west. Then we have the equator, which is having a center at zero. The center O is the center of the earth. And we have also have another parallel of latitude to the north now, because I want to get the relationship between the small r and the capital letter R. If you look at that now, the small r will be the radius of the latitude there, while the big R is the radius of the equator, which is the radius of the longitude also, which is the radius of the earth. So if you look at what is happening there, I only bring out the diagram there. Here, I will have this right angle triangle. So from our trigonometrical ratio, remember the Sokatwa, sine of an angle is equal to the opposite all over hypotenuse. Here now, we have what is our angle. Our angle here is, you know, I said we measure from equator to whichever latitude we are measuring. So if you start from my E to L now, from my E to L, you will see there will be an angle there. So that angle will be alternate to the other one. You know, the two lines, the two latitudes are parallel. So that means I have two parallel lines. Then a line which is the radius of the earth is crossing it. So we have the angle alpha to be equal to the angle alpha there, which is what? Which it is alternate. Those angles are alternate. So I brought that out. So from our trigonometrical ratio, we know the longest side, the side that is facing the 90 degree, is the one we call the hypotenuse, while the side that is facing the angle we are talking about is the opposite, while the other one is now the adjacent. Here now, I will have, from my diagram here, I have the hypotenuse and the what? And the adjacent. So if I should go to my trig ratio, you will remember that is cosine. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. So that is why I have cos of alpha to be equal to the small letter r all over the capital letter earth, which is radius of the latitude all over the radius of the earth, then it will be equal to the cosine of the latitude measured from the center of the earth, measured from the center of the earth to the latitude. So, which implies that my small letter r is equal to r cos the alpha. That means if I should cross multiply this, I will have r cos alpha to be equal to small letter r, where capital letter r is radius of the earth and the l is the latitude we are talking about. Then the circumference of the parallel of the latitude is 2 pi r. That is the total, you know, the total length of that circle. That is what we mean by the circumference of the circle is equal to 2 pi r, where r is the small letter r. 2 pi r, circumference of the latitude, that small latitude. So if it will now be longitude, now it will be capital letter r. If it is now the equator, it will be 2 pi capital letter r. But for the latitude, for other latitude, it will be what? Small letter r. Note, angular difference between two points of the same latitude that are in the same direction, in east and east or west and west, is the positive difference between the longitude. So what I mean here is that here now, if you look at this diagram now, here I'm talking about two latitudes now. The angular difference between these two latitudes from the center of the earth, that means I'm adding the equator to the latitude. The equator is 0 degrees, then this latitude will be its own. So addition of the two of them is the one that is giving me this alpha. So that is what I'm talking about here, that angular difference between points, between two points of the same latitude, that are angular difference between two points of the same latitude that are on the same direction, in east and east or west and west, east and east or west and west, is the positive difference between the longitude. Angular difference between two points on the same latitude that are in different directions, that is east and west, is the sum of the longitude. Angular difference between two points on the same longitude, so this is still the same. So if I should have a longitude in the western part, I have another longitude in the eastern part. So the angular difference between the two of them will be the addition of this longitude in the west and the longitude in the east. Likewise, the same for the latitude. Angular difference there, if I should have one to the north and another one to the south, so I will have to add, because the equator is at the middle, I have to add the two of them together. But if they are on the same place, that means you have if you have a longitude on the west and you have another longitude on the west, that means in that case we have to find the difference, we subtract them. Likewise for latitude 2, if you have the two of them in the north, we subtract. If you have the two of them in the south, we subtract. But if you have one in the north, one in the south, we add them together. Same for longitude. If you have the two of them in the east, we add them together. If you have the two of them in the west, we add them together. But if you have one in the west, another one in the south, we add them together. Then one in the west, one in the south, we subtract them. So that is that about that. The earth rotates from west to east through 360 degrees in 24 hours. The rotation of the earth in a particular point is the one that is helping us to know the time. In Nigeria, we can be around 3 o'clock. Then in another country, it can be 4 o'clock. It can be 5 o'clock in different country. So the earth will rotate round. It will complete its 360 degree rotation in 24 hours. So that one now, that is 360 in 24 hours. That means every hour we have to be 15 degrees. The earth will rotate, we move for 15 degrees in 1 hour. So in 1 degree, it should be 4 minutes. In 1 degree, it should be 4 minutes. So now let's go to the distance measured on the surface of the earth. For example, now let's look at this question. An aircraft moves from a point P, 28 degrees north and 15 degrees east, to another location T, 28 degrees north, 25 degrees west, and then to a location Q, 32 degrees south, 25 degrees west. Calculate the radius of P to T. Calculate the radius of P to T, the distance from P to Q, then the average speed of the aircraft if the journey takes 20 hours. Take the radius of the Earth to be 6,400 and pi to be 3.142. Now, according to the question, you know, I've told you initially that longitude is measured to the east or west, while latitude is measured to where? North or south. So our point P is on the northern part, so it has 28 degrees north, while the longitude is 15 degrees west. So that is what we can see here now. Our longitude is 28. Our latitude is 28 degrees to the north. You can see that. You can see it is a complete circle. And our longitude is 15 degrees to the east. So that is where our point P is. Likewise, our point T is on the same longitude, on the same latitude, 28 degrees to the north. And our longitude for that is 25 degrees to the west. So we can see that too. Now, our location of point Q, please, not have here, point Q, is the latitude there is 32 to the south, and the longitude there is 25 to the west. That means it is on the same longitude with town T. Now, let's now look at this. We can bring this out as a circle. Now, the radius of the parallel of latitude, we said it is R cos the latitude we are talking about. So, the latitude of what? Latitude of P to R. So, that means P to T, the latitude of P to T, that is latitude 28 degrees. So, that means our alpha there will be 28 degrees. Then, we take the radius of the Earth, which is 6,400 kilometers, to multiply the cos of 28, which gives us 5,650.56 kilometers. Now, the distance between the two, between P and T, look at this. The distance between P and T. You know, we said the total distance, circumference of a circle is what? 2 pi r. You remember that? That's the total circumference of that circle. Now, we now want to know a length of an arc. The arc, we've known the radius now. The radius is 5,650.56 kilometers. So, we now want to know the distance between T and P. So, that means we are cutting out this sector here. We cut out the sector there. So, to now find the length of that arc. So, if you are looking for the length of an arc, that would be the theta. The angle that arc subtend at the center, that is between the from the center of that latitude to town T and town P. So you know they are meeting at the center, which those two are radius. So we have an angle there, which is the angle it's subtending. So the length there, that is how we get theta over 360 times 2 pi small letter r, which is r cos alpha. So we have that calculation to give us the distance between the two of them as 3,946.35. So 40 degrees over 360. You know, you remember we said if we are having those longitude, in different half, one in the west, one in the east. We are going to add them together. So we have 15 degrees to the east, we have 25 degrees to the west. So that means we are adding them together. 15 plus 25 give us 40 degrees. So that is how we get the difference, angular difference between P and T, which is 15 plus 25 that give us 40 degrees. So our 40 degrees multiply by 2, multiply by pi, multiply by our radius, the small radius, the radius of that latitude, which give us the final answer to be 3,946.35 kilometer. Now, the distance between T and Q, now, you know, here also we have in different half. The first latitude is 28 degrees to the north, the second latitude is 32 degrees to the south. So the angular difference there will also be what? Addition. So we had the latitude 28 degrees with the latitude 32 degrees, which give us 60 degrees. We now find the distance. We now find the distance between the two of them. You know, our angle there is now 60 degrees. We now find the length of this arc. So the length of the arc, you remember, it is theta over 360 times 2 pi r. This time around is going to be the capital letter r, which is the radius of the arc. So our angular difference is 60. Our radius of the arc is 6,400. So we do the calculation as it is. 60 over 360 times 2 times 3.142 multiplied by 6,400 to give us 6,702.93 kilometers. Now, you remember from the question that that's the second question. The third question is asking about the speed of the aircraft if the total journey took 20 hours. The first journey, assuming we are starting from P, to T, the distance of P to T is 3,964. The distance from T to R is 6,702.93 kilometers. So that means the total distance covered will be the addition of the two distance, which is 10,648.28 kilometers. We remember, speed is equal to distance per time taken. That is distance over time. Total distance is 10,648.28 kilometer, and the total time taken is 20 hours. So when we divide the two, we have the approximate speed to be 5,532.4 kilometers per hour. So we can also see, this is another example. This is another example. We, as I've said in the beginning, that we use this to be able to know the distance between two towns, and also, you know, we also use it to know the time difference between the two towns. If you look at the example two now, we said P, town P, is 60 degrees north and 15 degrees to the east. 60 degrees north, that is the latitude, and 15 degrees east, that is the longitude of town P. So we'll be able to locate the point. We'll be able to locate the point, 60 and what? And 15 degrees. So we have been able to locate the point. So, and again, town Q is 60 degrees north, same longitude, and 48 degrees to the west. You can see that also we've been able to locate point Q also to the west. Now continue, and R, which is 30 degrees to the south and 48 degrees to the west, that means town R is on the same longitude with town Q. So that is that our town R. Are three places on the surface of the earth. Calculate a three significant figure. Please note that three significant figure. So at the end of the day, your answer should not be more than three significant figure. So you know what we mean by significant figure. Zero is not part of the significant figure, but we can still put zero, assuming we have, for example, now I'm talking about I have 109567. 109567. That is six figures. And I want three significant figures. You know, I said 1095. So I will take the first three, 109. So the other one will now be either to round up or to round off. So to add there, to be added to the next one. You know, zero has been counted now. So that is how a zero can be counted. But assuming I have 1, 2, 5, 3, 0, 0, those zero there will not be counted as figure. Those zeros there will not be counted as figures. So, but we have it like that. So, as I was saying, three significant figures. Now, the distance PQ measured along the latitude, the distance QR measured along the meridian. Meridian is another name for longitude. Meridian is another name for longitude. Then the time taken by the aircraft to cover the distance PQ and QR at an average speed of 800 kilometers per hour. We take the pi to be 3.142 and the radius of the Earth to be 6,400 kilometers. So that's the diagram. We can see the diagram. That's the diagram. So we look for the distance, the length of this arc QR and the length of the arc QR. QP and QR. So that will give us the distance. The distance between PQ, that is angular difference. Angular difference here, we are going to add them together. So the angular difference there is 63. We add 48 to 15. So we get the distance there, which is 3,520 kilometers. You know, it is 3,519 kilometers. But to three significant figure, we count 351. So the next one is 9, which is approximately, we round it up to 1 and now added it to the one behind the 5. So that is why we have 352. Then we turn that one to be 0, three significant figure. Then the distance QR, the angular difference there too is addition because they are in different half. So we have it as 60 plus 38, which is 98 degrees, all over 360 times 2 pi r. The previous one is small letter r, that is r cos alpha. The next one is big R because it is along the meridian, which is small circle. The previous one is along the latitude, which is small circle. So the other one is meridian, which is great circle. So the angular difference there is 98 degrees, so we have that. And the total distance there is 10,948 kilometers. So to three significant figure, we count 109, that is 1, 2, 3. So 4 is rounded off to 0. So we have 10900. So that means I have 10,900 kilometers to three significant figures. So the total distance traveled will be the addition from P to Q, then from Q to P. So that is, I will have 3519 plus 10,948 added together to give me 14,467 kilometers. So if the time taking, now look at this now. We are told that the average speed is this. You remember what is speed? Speed is what? Speed is distance all over time. So that means that we have 800, which is the speed, 800 kilometers per hour to be equal to 14,475 all over time taking. So that means time taking is the one I'm looking for. So that means my time taking will be what? Taking the cross multiplying, we have the time multiplied by the speed. So time multiplied by 800. So now our dividing both sides by 800. So I will have my time taking to be 14,467 divided by 800, which gives me 18.08 hours. 18.08 hours. So three significant figure, it will be 18.1 hours. Thank you and God bless. We check our assignment portals. We should check our assignment portals for more assignments. Thank you. God bless.